It's not worth it. I don't want to miss heaven. I don't want to miss New Orleans. But I'd like to see the Father. I've seen the Father. And a lot of these scientists don't understand the functions of the body. But they were all put there by our Lord Jesus Christ. All the functions of this body. And it all represented. You know, that's why Paul used the body as an example. And one that people take too far. He said, doesn't nature teach you that it's a shame for a man to have long hair? Well, he's speaking spiritual there. Because if you don't cut this hair, it's going to grow long. On a man, it's going to grow long. But here's the thing. There's one man to cover that situation. And he's got to keep all of that stuff that would cause it to go wrong trimmed away. That's the same thing that a minister does in his assembly. But naturally, if you don't cut your hair, it will grow long. I've had a lot of fall out. No, brother, you ain't supposed to have long hair. And then I'll wear a beard. I've had ministers jump on me about that. And I asked them, I said, did God make a mistake when he put hair on a man's face? Did God make a mistake? I worked outside all my life, and I found out what this facial hair is for. Brother, I've seen it cold. And I wouldn't shave it off for nothing in this world.
Amen.
Because it protected me. And not only that, it helped moisture, sweat, to keep my face cool. Because you didn't say you'd earn your keep by the sweat of your brow, by the sweat of your face. So, you know, I have reasons. Like I say, a lot of ministers, a matter of fact, some of them would let me in their pulpit or sit on the platform. So I got to be careful when I go somewhere. It don't bother me. If they want to believe it that way, that's fine. I keep my hair short. Matter of fact, it's not turning gray, it's turning loose. And that's my problem. My father was that way. He kept him coloring his hair, natural color, for way up in his 70s. And I've been thankful that that's been my case. Now then, is there any questions? Any comments?
No, sir. Thankful I'm the Lord with you.
Well, hey. Has anybody got a testimony? Nobody.
Hey.
How about you, brother? This is my first time meeting you. God does do things for you, doesn't he? Okay. Got agreement out of you, didn't I? But if there's nothing else to be said, how about we take up, who's going to do this? Who's going to take up the offer? One of you brethren that's a permanent member of you. Howard, that used to be your job. You had to give it up, hadn't you? You might get in trouble. Let's sing a song.
If I fall.
that I've known since the 70s. He's got diabetes. And he pastored a little church for a while and finally gave it up. Of course, mine went a different circumstance, and I won't get into that. But he's a man of God, loves God, laughs. You don't see him when he's not happier than laughing. And you can just get around. I like getting around. It makes me feel good. But I talked to him, and they had to rush him to the hospital. His name is Luke Winder. And put him on your prayer list, because he's the man you don't seldom find. And he's a blessing. Even if he don't say nothing, he's a blessing. Just the way he laughs. He laughs all over. His whole body laughs. And people like that's hard to find, especially nowadays. But I was talking to him. He said, well, he said, I woke up. I looked around. And he said, well, I guess I'm still on earth. That's the attitude he had. Death comes, so be it. But you know, all we got to deal with that attitude. That's why we want, as that song said, every step of the way.
Amen.
To keep us in his path. Yes. So remember him and we, sister, some of y'all, how many of y'all know Dean Skipper?
Yes.
All right, his mother fell and broke the bone inside her thigh. And they don't operate. I can't understand why I didn't get the fullness of it. I know Brother Skipper, which his dad's coming to church regularly now. Thank God for that. He's having to be a nursemaid or a
giver.
And she needs prayer, so remember her, Sister Skipper, is all you got to know. There's several Sister Skippers in there.
Yeah.
Well, there's one less now. I think the oldest girl got married and Dean's a pawpaw. I love Brother Dean. Pray for him. I try to make it up there once a month. It's a pretty long trip. Not as long as this. That's why I have to stay. But Dean's having trouble. There's a situation, and it's going to be in Chattanooga as far as I'm concerned from now until God ends it. Of course, each to his own belief. And I'm not going to discourage someone that's trying to work for the Lord. And I'm not going to tell him what I think. I'm going to let him go on, and if God wants him to know, he'll show it to him.
Amen.
I don't have to tell him. There's people there that's working against him. There's two assemblies, one in Chattanooga, one in Ringo. And they are working against him because I've heard a testimony from a lady that goes there, Brother Beans, how that the other church is trying to pull her away. That's no way to serve God. That's not righteousness. It's not righteousness at all. So pray for Brother Dean, because his wife had to go to work, and her work included her working on Sundays. And she don't get to be in church. And I try to help him all I can when I'm there. But it's so far and it's so hard on my wife. My wife just barely can get around the house. So I'm a caregiver too. But she's a saint of God. Yes. You know, your help me is a saint of God.
Yes.
You better treat them that way.
That's right. You better treat them right.
Because if you don't, you may not make it.
That's right. That's exactly.
You may not make it if you don't treat them that way. Because they're a child of God just like you. And pray for her. Pray for that assembly there. And pray for the other. Maybe get it. It's just a testing of Brother Skipper's will. I don't know. But pray that the other one won't have that kind of attitude. But live and let live. You know? I think Louisville at one time had three assemblies. Brother James Souders and Brother Jolly, James Souders was up there. Who was the other one?
I'm trying to get it. They're coming forward.
Okay. And the little short guy up there now trying to take it. carefree. That's Brother Luke's best buddy. He's taking care of a church in Louisville. Now, I don't know which one it was, but I've been to Brother James Souders before he passed away. I went up there and picked up Mom Davis. Mom Davis and I were good buddies. And I used to go over there and see her. Matter of fact, I was disrespected doing it over the pulpit. That's not a righteous way either. She's a saint of God. I wasn't disrespecting him. But anyhow, pray for the situation there and let God have his way and let him, the people see his way. Because some people, you know, they feel like that they're doing the will of God. Well, I'm not going to tell them they're not. I'm going to let God do that. He can do it a lot better than I can. Some of them, I might end up with a bloody nose. And I don't need that. No. But pray for that situation.
Remember Josh, he's homesick today.
Josh, I hope he hasn't got the flu.
Me neither.
You know, I got a shot for the flu early in October.
Yeah.
Come find out it ain't no good.
23% effective, and it will, on an old person, it will help you to reserve what you have. But there's four new strains out, and it's on the internet.
Right. Yeah. Okay. Well, I'm
going to remember the Wallace family. That's
yes.
Mary and his family, and Lee and his family.
How is Lee?
He is upbeat as usual. Okay. I haven't looked at his labs this week. I always get so nervous when I look at him.
Sister.
Yeah, I do.
Please. And
yeah, I know what you've told me. I know what you have told me.
Okay.
And remember the assemblies there, Cross Plains, Brother Farmer, and Brother Heimer in Bowling Green, Kentucky. There's a lot of good folks that goes to both of those assemblies.
Yes.
And it come out of Brother William Souders.
Yes.
There are, in those assemblies, there's a lot of different kinds of things that didn't come from Brother Souders. Men put their hands on things.
Right, they build their stakes.
Uh-huh. And, you know, God knows all about it. God knows all about it. But what I'm to do is be a Christian, and Brother Charles Blunt used to say, do it right.
Right.
You do it right. And I remember him saying that when there was something really bad in the assembly in Bradenton. I remember Charles Blunt. And that makes me know that there is a God, and there are a few, and there's going to be a remnant. There'll be a remnant within each assembly. The core that God touches, and they will get the word of life written on their heart, as Brother Fletcher was saying. It will be written on our heart that we will want to do the right thing, a righteous way.
Right.
In Jeremiah 6 and 16, I think, it says something about look for the old path, seek the old path,
right.
For in them there is a good way.
Right.
There's a good way. Yes. And really, we're sitting in a place today.
Amen.
That there is a good way.
Yes,
and my younger brother that sits in Bradenton, he is always so upbeat. I can't understand it, but that's how he is. And I appreciate that God gives all of us a little talent.
Right.
Every one of us, if we're called, chosen and faithful to him, He gives us a little talent.
Yeah.
And everybody's talent is not the same.
Amen.
And everybody's talent is not the same. I didn't mean to say anything, but thank God for our families.
Yeah.
I appreciate that we have saints in this assembly.
Amen.
That has stood by the ministry because they knew it was the right way to go.
Right.
I would not have had a place to come if Sister Wilma Lane hadn't been standing beside where God put her. See, when God puts you somewhere, you better stay there.
Amen.
Because you never know who you will influence.
Amen.
How good God is, I really feel the Spirit of the Lord. I feel the stableness of the service, Brother Fletcher. I feel the stableness
yes.
of this service.
Right.
I'm thankful to be here. Yes. I am thankful.
Right. You spoke of Brother Farmer. Is that the one that he took over Brother Mears?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I used to go up there.
Yes.
When we had nowhere to go in Chattanooga. It was up. Goodlitzville. It
yes.
was there that time. Mm-hmm. And I used to go up there, and there was 200, 250 people there.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And while I understand they're having services in, not in the sanctuary, but somewhere else. I don't know what it's like, the cafeteria or something.
It's the dining room. They have a million and a half building there.
And you know what? Million and a half buildings is a big building.
But there ain't many people there.
Right. But this tongue is a world of iniquity.
Yes, it is. Yes,
it has killed many a minister.
Yes, it has.
Has caused people to lose their faith in God.
Yeah.
Because a tongue is a terrible thing.
Sets on fire the course of hell.
Yeah.
Scripture says sets on fire the course of hell.
It's what it will do, and that's what's happened in these assemblies.
Amen.
Exactly.
But I one thing that I see right. and look at, I'll just hold you a little while longer and then we'll pray. There's 15 wise, I think it has to go, 15 wise, 15 foolish. 10 wise, 10 foolish. 10 wise, 10 foolish. 5 wise.
10 virgins, 5 wise, 5 foolish.
Okay.
Yeah.
See, their numbers slipped me. Foolish. And they're both virgins.
Yeah, yes, they are.
So half of this group of people that has this truth are going to be foolish. Because you know what? They just have knowledge and not understanding. Mm-hmm. And that's what's going to get them. He's going to tell them, depart from me, ye workers of iniquity, I never knew you. He never fathered them. They took it upon themselves. I never knew you. And knew in the Bible means to father. And has anybody else got anything? Yes, ma'am.
I just want to thank you for the word, Brother Eddie, and I want to thank you for a church that's blessed that will bring you the word that will feed you. Because I went to a church.
Bless
you. They weren't preaching out of the King James Bible, but when I came here, I got the word fed to me, and I just wanted to say, in Psalms 91, you dwell in a secret place.
Yes, he does.
And
amen.
That secret place could be going to your, like, to your room and dwelling on the Lord by just giving him time. Well,
that's right.
And
yes.
So I just want to say, I'm thankful for a church
that will
feed you the word, and I'm thankful
for
the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Pastor here, I back him 100% because he's leading this people toward that city, that holy city.
Yes.
And the heart is singing that song.
Amen.
Leaving battling far behind.
Amen.
Foolish virgins too. All right, let's all stand and pray.
Yes.
Remember all these requests, especially ministers, is fighting a battle. I know I've been through it. Precious Lord, we come to you in this hour. Thanking you, Lord, for what you've done for us today. We ask, God, that you keep your hand upon each and every one of these people and take care of them as they go their different ways, Lord. We know that they're your children, and you will do that for them. And we pray, God, that you'll bless them the next time they return. And Lord, we pray that you'll be in their lives and help them to take all the words that's been given from everyone, not just me, everyone, and put it in their heart and let it be a guideway for them, a light into their path that they can follow you. And we give you the praise and honor in your precious name, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.